Let's discuss the social rights of a mother in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 23 and 24, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْحَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا وَاحْفِظْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. And the Lord has decreed that you worship none but Him, and to be kind to your parents, whether one or both of them attain old age. Say not a word of contempt, nor rebel them. Do not even say off to them, but address them in terms of humility, and say, My Lord, have mercy on them, even as they cherished me in my childhood. You have to respect your parents, whether one or both of them attain old age. You cannot even say off to them, but you have to lower your wings of humility. And you have to say, My Lord, have mercy on them, even as they cherished me in my childhood. The glorious Quran uplifts a woman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 1, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ. Respect the womb that bore you. Pregnancy uplifts a woman and does not degrade her. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah An'am, chapter number 6, verse number 151, and in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 23, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be good to your parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 14, and in Surah Ahqaf, chapter number 46, verse number 15, وَوَصَّيْنَا لِإِحْسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. And we have enjoined upon man kindness to his parents, especially your mother. And that the hadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Sunan Ibn Majah, volume number 4, Book of Jihad, hadith number 2781, as well as in Musnad Ahmad, volume number 3, hadith number 15538. Paradise lies beneath the feet of your mother. It does not mean that if you're walking on the road and if your mother, she steps on any muck or filth, that thing becomes paradise. It means that if you love your mother, if you respect your mother, if you are kind to your mother, you will inshallah enter paradise. And it is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 8, Book of Adab, hadith number 5971. جاء رجل إلى الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال يا رسول الله من أحق الناس بحسن صحابتي قال أمك قال ثم من قال ثم أمك قال ثم من قال ثم أمك قال ثم من قال ثم أبوك رواه بخاري. A man approached the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Who deserves most of my love, respect and companionship? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Your mother. The man asked, Who's next? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Your mother. The man asked, Who's next? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Your mother. The man asked for the fourth time, Who's next? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Your father. In short, 75%, that is 3/4 of a companionship of the children, goes to the mother. And 25%, 1/4 of the companionship of the children, goes to the father. In short, the mother gets the gold medal. She gets the silver medal. She gets the bronze medal. The father has to be satisfied with a mere consolation prize. These are the teachings of Islam. Let's discuss the social rights of a sister in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 71, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. And the believers, men and women, are protectors of one another. And it is mentioned in Sunan al-Tirmizi, Book of Purification, hadith number 113. إِنَّمَا النِّسَاءُ شَقَائِقُ الرِّجَالِ. The women are the shaqaiq of the men. The word shaqaiq means half, as the world is divided into approximately half females and half males. And the other meaning is that she is your sister, unless otherwise. The woman, she is your sister, unless otherwise. Just because the social rights of women in Islam are equal to that of a man, what would you say? The woman's rights in Islam, they are modernizing or they are outdated.